stage, we will explore muscle tissue. Muscle tissue is specialized to contract. To contract means to shorten. So muscle tissue, because of its microanatomy and subcellular structures, shortens as a result of a series of biochemical reactions. And that shortening of the muscle will cause movement of something. Now, if it's skeletal muscle tissue, it will cause movement of the skeleton. If it's cardiac muscle tissue, it will cause the heart to contract, which will propel blood through the chambers. And if it's smooth muscle, it will narrow a passageway, moving a substance through it. Okay, so all of the muscle tissues share some things in common, but then also have differences. Let's start with skeletal muscle tissue. Skeletal muscle tissue is found in all of the voluntary muscles of the body. So, the gluteus maximus, the biceps brachii, the masseter, that's in your face, the gastrocnemius, latissimus dorsi, trapezius. You're going to learn all of these muscles when we do the muscular system. But all of these muscles are voluntary. You can consciously decide to contract them. There's even a place in your brain where that initiation begins. And so skeletal muscle has a very unique appearance. We will explore it in detail when we do the muscular system. But it's characterized by long cylindrical cells. Those cells are multinucleated. That means each cell has more than one nucleus. Because those cells are so long, they need more than one nucleus. One just wouldn't be enough. There's a striated or banded appearance that these cells have, and it's because of a subcellular structure that we will discuss called the sarcomere that it has this banded appearance. As I said, skeletal muscle is voluntary, and it's found in all of the skeletal muscles, or your voluntary muscles of the body. Cardiac muscle tissue, as the name implies, is found in the heart. The heart wall has cardiac muscle tissue, and when it contracts, it will narrow those chambers. There are four chambers in the heart. We will discuss the heart in a later unit. But when those chambers contract or narrow, the substance inside the chambers, which is blood, will move through the heart from the right atrium to the right ventricle. Then it will propel out of the heart and go over to the lungs. When blood returns to the heart, it will return to the left atrium. And then the heart contracts and pushes that blood into the left ventricle. Blood then leaves the heart, because the left ventricle contracts and pushes that blood out the heart through the aorta. All of this is involuntary. You cannot consciously decide to contract the heart muscle tissue. It's controlled autonomically and also intrinsically. Don't let that stress you out yet. We'll talk about that when we get to that unit. Cardiac muscle cells are always described as being short and branched. Rather than being long and cylindrical, like skeletal muscle cells, cardiac muscle cells are short and branched. They're usually uninucleated. Maybe they're binucleated. So they either have one, maybe two nuclei per cell. These cells also have a banded appearance. So the tissue looks sort of striped or banded. That term is striated. And it's because of that intracellular structure called a sarcomere that it shortens as well. So skeletal muscle and cardiac muscle are both striated. Now, smooth muscle looks very different from those two other types of muscle tissue. It's described as being fusiform in shape. That means spindle-shaped, cat-eye-shaped. It's definitely not striated. These cells only have one nucleus. They're never multinucleated. Now, smooth muscle is also involuntary. It's controlled by the autonomic nervous system. So you cannot consciously decide to contract smooth muscle. Smooth muscle is found in the walls of hollow organs. Examples of hollow organs are the stomach, the small intestine, the large intestine, the uterus, all blood vessels, the urinary bladder, the gallbladder. So all of these hollow organs have a layer inside of them that bears smooth muscle. And when that muscle contracts, it will narrow or constrict that organ. Whatever substance is inside of that organ, if it's the stomach, it's going to be called chyme. The urinary bladder, that substance is called urine. If it's a blood vessel, that substance is called blood. And so smooth muscle moves fluids, propels substances through the body from one location to another. Okay, so muscle tissue, so all of these muscle tissues contract. They do it by shortening, and when those cells shorten, it causes the overall structures around them to also narrow, shorten, or move.